This is Devan with the UNF Student Wellness Complex. I'm going to take you guys through a power yoga class. All you'll need is a mat. As usual, I'll give plenty of modifications as we go, so you can feel free to take any that you like. Feel free to add in any of your own. If you have a block, strap, stack of books, anything that you'd like to use, feel free to go grab that, and we will go ahead and get started in child's pose. So we're going to start knees wide to the edges of our mat. Toes together, sitting back towards our heels, palms pressing into our mat. Just take a few breaths here. Inhaling through your nose, exhaling out your mouth. So if you'd like to set an intention for your practice, feel free to do that here. And you can just shift the hips side to side. Maybe walk the fingertips a little bit closer to the top of the mat. Bring you back a little bit closer towards the heels. And then go ahead and take that right arm. We're just gonna thread it right underneath of that left. So dropping that right shoulder to the mat. Walking those fingertips a little bit closer to the top of the mat. Or if it feels better, you can take that left arm behind your back. Inhale, come on back to center. Exhale here. Inhale, come on up. We're going to take that left arm, thread it underneath of the right this time. Drop that left shoulder down. Taking those fingertips a little bit higher. We're wrapping that right arm behind your back here. Inhale back to center, exhale here. For our next inhale, coming up into tabletop. Shoulders over your elbows, over your wrists, hips over your knees. Take a few cat-cows just to loosen up the spine. So as you inhale, rolling the shoulders back, pulling the belly button down towards your mat. Exhale, rounding through the back, tucking the chin, looking towards your knees, or maybe your belly button. Inhale, pulling that belly button back down towards your mat, lifting the tailbone. Exhale, rounding through the spine. One more each direction, so big inhale here. Exhale, rounding. Inhale, come on back to center. We're going to come in and just drop the hips over to the right a little bit. Back to center and over to the left. Back to center. So go ahead and take the left palm, flip it face up, fingertips pointing towards your knees. Same thing with the right. We'll just stretch out the wrists a little bit. So if this is good, you can stay here. If you want a little bit more, you can start to sit back towards your heels a little bit. Time flew. We were so poor and lost back then. And then taking the palms face down, fingertips pointing out towards the sides of the mat. Just shifting your weight left to right. Just enough to make do. Things were never easy, but we were strong together. This one and one made two. So I'll drive all night. And then take the hands back to normal, fingertips facing the top of the mat. We're going to tuck the toes, press the hips up and back, downward facing dog. So heels pressing down towards the mat. You can pedal out the feet a little bit here. Pull you close when it's hectic. You're feeling disconnected. Rolling the shoulders away from the ears, pressing down through all 10 fingertips. And then go ahead and bend just the right knee. We're gonna drop that right hip down towards the mat, so you should feel a nice stretch through the back of that left leg. Right leg, we'll switch. So bending the left leg, dropping that left hip towards your mat, stretching out the back of that right leg. And straighten out that left leg. Go ahead and slowly walk both feet up to meet your hands. We're going to come into a forward fold or maybe ragdoll, grabbing opposite elbows if that feels better. Maybe swinging side to side if you'd like. You can shake your head forward or backward, or maybe side to side. Just a gap to you. I'll keep you warm when it's cold outside. Interlacing the fingers together behind you, pressing the hands up toward the ceiling, opening up the chest. Inhale, slowly rolling the whole way up. Both arms are going to come overhead. Take a little back bend here, pressing the hips forward. Exhaling, hands to heart center. So go ahead and hop up to the top of your mat if you're not already there. Inhale, both arms overhead. Exhale, do forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back, hands come to your shins. Exhale, fold. Step or jump your feet back. For this first one, as usual, we're going to go ahead and drop down to the knees, keeping those elbows tucked in. Go ahead and slowly lower all the way down. And stay on the mat. We're going to press up just as far as you feel comfortable into cobra. So thighs pressing into the mat, shoulders rolled away from the ears. And slowly lower back down. Go ahead and tuck the toes. Press yourself up and back down with facing dog. So that is your first option for any of your chaturangas tonight. I'll give you another one as we go through the next round. So walk, step, or jump both feet between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, come on up, arms overhead. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, forward fold, plant the hands, step or jump your feet back. This time we're gonna inhale, roll forward on the toes, keeping those elbows tucked in, lower down halfway. Untuck the toes, inhale to upward facing dog. Exhale as you tuck the toes, downward facing dog. So that is your second option. If you get tired of them at all, you can always just skip them and step yourself back to downward facing dog too. Totally up to you. Go ahead and walk, step or jump both feet between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, hold. Inhale, come on up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, chaturanga. So any variation you'd like here. So from here, go ahead and drop down to your forearms. We're going to come into dolphin. So keeping those hips lifted, pressing down through the heels, pressing the shoulders away from the ears. And go ahead and inhale that right leg up toward the ceiling. From here, we're going to bend that right knee and open up that right hip. So try to tuck that right hip over top of the left. And then drop that right leg down. We'll switch sides. So inhaling that left leg towards the ceiling. Bending that left knee. And opening up that left hip, stacking it on top of the right. Coming back to center, dropping that left leg, pressing back up into downward facing dog. And then walk, step, or jump both feet between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come on up. Exhale, hands to heart center. So from here, we're going to come into chair. You can stay at the top of your mat. We're going to take toes together, heels about an inch apart, and we're going to sit back. So tailbone tucked under. Hands can come to heart center, or you can bring them up by your ears, up to you. So shifting the weight back into your heels. Maybe you lift up and wiggle the toes a little bit. Relax the shoulders. Maybe sink the hips a little bit deeper. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, lifting that right leg toward the ceiling. Exhale as you step it through between your hands, warrior one. So left heel comes flat on your mat, pressing through the outer edge of that left leg. Inhaling both arms overhead. So go ahead and check, make sure that right knee is stacked over the right ankle. Sinking a little bit deeper into that right leg. Bringing both hands to your mat. Go ahead and step that right foot back. Chaturanga. Inhaling the left leg towards the ceiling. Go ahead and step it between your hands, warrior one on this side. So this time, right heel's planted, pressing through the outer edge of that right foot. Stacking that left knee over the left ankle. Hips squared towards the top of the mat. Relaxing your shoulders here. And dropping both hands to your mat, stepping that left foot back, chaturanga. Walk, step, or jump with feet between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, hold. Inhale, coming the whole way up. Exhaling, hands to heart center. So we're going to come back into chair. This time we're going to add in a little twist. So starting at center, tailbone tucked under, weight is back in your heels. And we're going to start with a twist to the right. So left elbow is going to go to the outside of that right knee. So really using that left elbow to press yourself up and away from the knees. Try not to sink into it. And you can go ahead and look back. Just make sure those knees are in line with each other here. If you practice side crow, you're welcome to take that here. Performing just like my Rari. You're too fine, need a ticket. I bet you taste expensive. Pumping up, up, up on a leader. You keeping up, you should keep it. Tequila and vodka. Girl, you might be. So you can stay here, or you can maybe try to lift up that right leg behind you. My heart wanna stay, wanna stay, wanna stay, wanna stay now. You can see it in my eyes that I'm gonna take it down. Go ahead and come on back to center. Make sure that tailbone is still tucked under here. And then we're going to twist over to the left. So right elbow to the outside of that left knee. Using your arms to press yourself up and away from the knees. And feel free to either stay here, come into side crow, or maybe try to kick that left leg up behind you. And then come back to center. Exhale, fold here. Let's stay here for a second. Maybe let the head hang. Shake out the legs if you need to. And then on your next inhale, come on up halfway lift. Exhale as you fold and shatter back. Inhale, lifting that right leg behind you. Exhale, as you step it between your hands, we're going to come to warrior two this time. So hips square towards the side of your mat. So relaxing the shoulders here. Squeeze over that front middle finger. Inhale, go ahead and flip that right palm face up. We're going to reach forward as far as we can. And then go ahead and take that right arm overhead, drop that left arm down your back leg. Maybe wrap it behind your low back if that feels better. Inhale, back to warrior two. And from here, go ahead and straighten out that right leg. Inhale, reaching forward as far as we can again. And then dropping that right arm down towards your mat. Opening up with that left arm. So right hand can come down to your mat if you'd like. It can come to a stack of books or a block. Wherever you're at, trying to stack the shoulders on top of the hips. Keeping everything in one line here. So if it helps, you can even bring your hand up to that right shin, ankle, wherever you're comfortable. If you're good here, you can also take that left arm behind your back. Work on opening up that left shoulder a little bit more. We're going to bring both hands to the mat. Step that right foot back to meet the left and chaturanga. So inhale, lifting that left leg this time. Stepping that left leg between your hands. We're going to come up warrior two on this side. So hips square towards the side of the mat. Arms out wide. Left knee stacked over the ankle. Relaxing the shoulders here. Inhale, flipping that left palm face up, reaching forward as far as you can. And then taking that left arm overhead, dropping that right arm to your back leg. We're wrapping it behind your back here. Keeping us together. Inhale, back to warrior two. One day we're gonna wake up. Go ahead and straighten out that left leg. We're gonna reach forward as far as we can one more time. And then dropping that left arm to your mat, block, shin, ankle, wherever you're comfortable. We're lifting those right fingertips towards the ceiling. Maybe taking that right arm behind your back if that feels good, opening up that right shoulder. Good, if that arm is wrapped, go ahead and bring it back up toward the ceiling. Then we're going to drop both hands to the mat, step that left foot back to meet the right, and chaturanga. Walk, step, or jump with feet between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, coming the whole way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. So this time we're gonna come back into chair, but we're gonna do just one leg. So we'll take left ankle on top of the right thigh to start. So pressing down through that left thigh, knee, sitting back, shifting your weight into the back of that left or right heel, keeping that tailbone tucked under. So from here, go ahead and uncross that left leg, bring that left knee up to your chest. Stand up nice and tall, rolling the shoulders back. Then we're going to kick that left leg behind us and drop it down into crescent lunge. So if you're comfortable, you can stay here. You can also drop down to that left knee if you'd like. So up to you, take whichever option you'd like. Stay here, rolling the shoulders back. And then go ahead and start to just extend the arms overhead. Sink the hips a little bit deeper. Maybe pressing that left hip forward a little bit more, pulling that right hip back. Exhaling, hands are going to come to heart center, and then we're going to drop that left hand down to the mat on the inside of the right foot. Inhale, open up with that right arm. Take a nice little twist here. Right arm down. If you're not already there, we're going to drop that left knee to the mat for a low lunge. And then we're going to walk that right foot out wide to the edge of the mat. And we're going to come into lizard. So you've got a few options. You can stay here on your palms. You can drop down to one forearm, maybe both. If you have a block or stack of books, you can come onto that. You can also let this right knee roll out to the side so you're on the outer edge of that right foot. So find wherever you're comfortable. We'll take a few breaths here. Inhale, go ahead and slowly press yourself back up, pull that right knee in. We're going to tuck those left toes under, step that right foot back, chaturanga. Walk step or jump both feet between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come on up. Exhaling, hands are going to come to heart center. We're going to do the same thing on the other side. So this time, right ankle crosses over top of the left thigh. Sitting the hips back, tucking the hips under. Weight is back in that left heel. Wanna lie to you, say I'm doing so well. Nice straight flat back here. Maybe sink the hips a little bit deeper. We all try to do. I'm scared to call you back. I'm no good at trying to tell you that I'm not doing. Go ahead and straighten out through that left leg, pulling that right knee up to your chest. Out nice and tall, rolling the shoulders back. We're gonna take that right leg back behind us. Drop down to the mat for either crescent lunge, or again, drop that right knee all the way down for low lunge. So take a few breaths here. Maybe pulling that left hip back, passing the right hip forward. And just extending the arms out overhead, sinking the hips a little bit deeper. Relaxing the shoulders. Exhaling hands to heart center. We're going to drop that right hand to the inside of that left foot. Inhaling that left arm overhead. Taking a little twist here. Just take a breath, love. Fill your lungs up. Rest your head. There's no sense in losing sleep. You can break down. Let your heart stop. Dropping that left hand to your mat, we're going to drop down to that right knee if you're not already there. Then go ahead and walk that left foot out wide to the edge of your mat. Feel free to take any variation you'd like to on this side for lizard. So again, you can stay here, maybe drop down to the forearms, maybe let that left knee roll out wide. So a few breaths here. On your next inhale, go ahead and slowly come on back up. We're going to tuck that left knee back in. Tuck the right toes under. Set the left foot back to meet the right, and chaturanga. So go ahead and inhale, roll yourself forward to a plank here. We're going to hold, so keeping that tailbone tucked under. We're going to go ahead and open up to a side plank, so right hand or forearm to the center of your mat. Inhale, open up with that right arm. If you want a little bit less, you can drop down to that right knee. If you want a little bit more, you can lift up that left leg. Up to you. Lift those hips a little bit higher. And then go ahead and roll yourself back to center. We'll switch sides. So left hand or forearm to the center of your mat. Inhale, open up with that right arm. Again, same options. Left knee, right leg. Lifting the hips a little bit higher on this side. Inhale back to center. And back to downward facing dog. Go ahead and walk step or jumbo feet between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, come on up. Exhaling, hands are gonna come to heart center. We'll do a little bit of balance. So we're gonna start with eagle. Left leg is gonna wrap over top of the right. If you want, you can keep those toes on the mat for a little extra stability. And then, so left leg over, left arm is gonna go underneath the right. So just wrapping as many times as you can here, sinking down into that right leg. Pulling up through the arms. Challenge what the future holds. Try to keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead and unwrap just the legs this time. We're going to take that left leg out behind us for warrior three. So keeping the arms twisted. Pulling the chest up away from the floor. And then unwrapping the arms, we're going to lift that leg a little bit higher for standing split. comfortable, you can maybe let go of the ground, maybe grab a hold of your ankle with one of your hands, or maybe both. Drop that left leg down, go ahead and shake them out, and slowly come back up, and we'll switch sides. So this time, right leg is going to wrap over the left, right arm underneath of the left. So sinking down into that bottom leg, looking through the arms. Unwrapping just the legs, kicking that right leg back behind you. Bound warrior three. So again, lifting through the chest here. Trying to keep one straight line from your fingertips all the way to that right foot. I see what you're wearing. There's nothing beneath it. Forgive me for staring. Forgive me for breathing. And unwrapping the arms, lifting that right leg a little bit higher for standing split. Shake out your legs, and then go ahead and inhale, slowly coming all the way up, both arms overhead, exhaling, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog, exhale, downward facing dog. So go ahead and inhale, lifting that right leg for the ceiling. What's left of this moment, I'm not gonna waste it. Exhale, right knee is gonna come to right wrist, right angle to left wrist. We're gonna drop that left knee to the mat and come into the pigeon. So you can tuck that right knee back until it's comfortable for you. Make sure that right knee is outside of the right hip. Then we're gonna inhale, lengthen the spine. As you exhale, walk both hands straight out in front of you. So making sure that left hip is tucked down towards your mat. You can also take that left arm and thread it underneath of the right arm here. If this is too much on your knees or hips, you can always roll yourself over. Take a figure four stretch on your back. So right knee on the left thigh, right ankle on the left thigh. Hold that left knee in, and then a squeeze. You should feel it through the back of this right leg and glute. So we're going to slowly come on back up. We're going to bend that left knee, reach that left arm back, grab a hold of that foot and pull it towards you. So pressing your hips forward and down towards your mat. Right leg out behind you. And then drop that right foot down. Inhale, the left leg behind you. Exhale, left knee is going to come to left wrist, left ankle to right wrist. We're going to drop that right knee to the mat. When you're ready, inhale, lengthening the spine. Exhale, walking both hands out in front of you. Maybe rolling over onto your back.
left ankle on right thigh if you'd like to take a figure four stretch on your back. Maybe threading that right arm underneath of the left. Go ahead and reach that right arm back, grabbing a hold of that right foot, crossing the hips forward and down towards the mat. Between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, hold. Inhale, coming the whole way up. Exhaling, both hands to heart center. So we are going to come into chair again. So go ahead and come over to the side of your mat this time. We're going to take our feet wide to about hip distance apart. And we're going to sit back. So tailbone still tucked under. Hands are going to come to heart center. From here, we're going to press up to the toes. Go up as far as you can on the balls of your feet, sinking the hips a little bit deeper. Go ahead and drop the heels. We're going to walk the feet a little bit wider. And then come all the way down for a deep squat. So elbows to the inside of your thighs, pressing them open, sitting up nice and tall here, so try not to slouch over. If you practice crow here, headstand, tripod, feel free to take any of those variations. If this is too much, you can also sit on a block or a stack of books here. Whenever you're ready, we're going to go ahead and plant the hands on the mat in front of us, straighten out the legs, and walk them a little bit wider. So we're going to come into a wide leg forward fold. You can keep your palms on your mat, you can drop down to your forearms, or maybe the top of your head here. Wherever you're comfortable, go ahead and just shift your weight side to side, bending through one knee and then the other. Stretching out the hips and inner thighs. And then coming back to center. Maybe just letting the head hang here for a few breaths. So from here, we're going to go ahead and turn the right toes towards the top of the mat, towards the back of the mat, wherever you're at. And we're just going to walk our hands over towards that right leg, bringing your nose down towards that right knee. So you should feel a nice stretch through the back of this right leg. And then go ahead and turn the toes back towards the side of the mat. Keep your head over there. So readjust if you need to, but this time you should be able to stretch through the side and a little bit through the back of that right leg.
Walking our hands back to center. We're going to turn those left toes out this time. When you're ready, go ahead and walk your hands over towards that left leg, dropping your nose towards that left knee. Turning those toes back again towards the side of the mat. Readjusting and then again, nose towards that left foot. Inhale, both hands back to center. We're going to walk the feet in a little bit. Heels are going to face each other, toes pointed outwards. So we're going to come up into temple. So keeping the tailbone tucked under here, knees stacked over the ankles. Hands are going to come to heart center. And then we're going to press up to the toes here. So sinking the hips a little bit deeper. Shoulders roll back. Dropping those hips a little bit more. And dropping those heels. Hands are going to come to the inner thighs. We're going to twist over to the left. So pressing away on that right thigh. And under the left elbow. Inhale back to center. Exhale, twisting to the right, so pressing away on that left thigh. Inhale, center, and one more to each side. So exhale to the right. Inhale, center. And over to the other side. Back to center. Go ahead and straighten out the legs. We're going to plant the hands and just walk the feet together. From here, go ahead and just slowly roll the whole leg up. Both arms are going to come overhead. We're going to take that right hand, grab a hold of the left wrist. So we're just going to lean over to the right. So pressing your hips towards the left side. Should have a nice stretch through the outside of this whole left side body. Inhale back to center, switch sides. So left fingertips grab the right wrist. Exhale, you lean over to the left. Inhale back to center, go ahead and release the arms. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, plant the hands at the top of your mat if you're not there. Step or jump the feet back, chaturanga. So from here, go ahead and inhale, roll yourself forward into a plank. Exhale, slowly lower all the way down. We're going to come onto our back. We're going to do a little bit of abs. So we're going to do some bicycles, but we're going to do single leg bicycles. So we'll do all on one side and then all on the other side. You can go at your own pace. I'll just show you what we're going to do. So to start, right leg is going to go out long. Actually, both legs can go out long. We'll start left knee to right elbow. So you're just going to crunch right elbow, left knee. Inhale, extend out long. Exhale, same side. So right elbow, left knee. We'll do 8 on this side. And then when you're finished, you'll switch 8 of your left knee to your, no, right knee to your left elbow. So 8 on each side. Whenever you're ready, go for it. When you're finished, you can roll yourself over into child's pose. And feel free to go as fast or as slow as you need to here. Thank you.
whenever you're finished, when you're in child's pose, go ahead and just take a few breaths here. And then when you're ready, we're just going to come all the way down onto our stomachs. Legs out long, arms are going to go out wide to the sides. Right cheek is going to come onto your mat. And then on your next inhale, we're going to lift that left leg behind us. Bending the left knee, taking that left foot across all the way to the floor on the outside of the right leg. So you've got a few options here again. You can stay here with your arms out wide. Left knee bent. You can also take that left arm behind your back. Just wrap it behind your back. Maybe interlace the fingers together. You can grab a hold of that left foot with either the right or the left hand. If you want to stretch the shoulders, you can walk those right fingertips up towards the top right corner of the mat. So again, any option you'd like, feel free to take it here. Left cheek goes on the mat. As you inhale, lifting that right leg this time, bending the right knee, taking that right foot to the floor on the outside of the left leg. One more big inhale here. Exhale, let it out. And as you inhale, rolling back to center, drop that right leg. We're going to come onto our backs. And then we're going to come into bridge next. So feet are going to go flat on the mat. Arms by your sides, maybe walking your heels up towards your fingertips. And then when you're ready, we're gonna press down through the heels, lifting the hips, squeezing the knees towards each other. And then go ahead and just roll the shoulders underneath of you, maybe interlacing the fingers together, pressing the hips a little bit higher. Go ahead and pull the shoulders out, lower the hips, bring both knees into your chest, maybe rock side to side. And we'll take one more. So if you want to press up into wheel this time, you're more than welcome to. Wherever you're at, go ahead and plant your feet back on your mat, arms either by your sides or up by your ears for wheel if that's where you're headed. When you're ready, pressing down through the heels, lifting the hips, either interlacing the fingers underneath of you or straightening out the arms for the wheel. And then from here, wherever you are, we're going to press up to the toes again here. Maybe walk the feet in a little bit closer, maybe lift the hips a little bit higher. Squeezing the knees a little bit closer. can go ahead and slowly lower all the way back down, pulling your knees into your chest, rocking side to side. And then go ahead and extend that left leg out. You can take it out long, or you can plant that left foot back on the mat to support your lower back. We're just gonna extend that right foot up toward the ceiling. So relaxing the shoulders, grabbing a hold of that right leg anywhere that's comfortable for you. So that can be behind your thigh, shin, ankle. And grab your toes and pull them towards you. And then go ahead and just take a few circles with that right ankle. Switching directions. On that right leg a little bit closer. And then go ahead and take that right leg across your body over to the left. Let that right arm fall out to the side. Yourself back to center. Get that right knee a squeeze into your chest. And then we'll switch sides. So go ahead and release that right leg down to your mat. Inhale, pull that left knee into your chest. And then extend that left leg straight up toward the ceiling. So relax the shoulder, but then go ahead and just take a few circles with that left ankle. Switching directions. Pulling that left leg a little bit closer. And then if you want to take that left leg across your body over to the right side, you can bend that left knee for a little bit less here. Chest, maybe rocking side to side here, maybe rocking forward and backward if that feels better. And when you're ready, go ahead and release your knees, just find a comfortable spot on your mat. We're just going to lay here and relax for a minute. So letting go of any tension you're holding on to. Just taking a few deep breaths. Letting your body sink down into your mat.
stay here for as long as you'd like, but if you're ready to get on with the rest of your day, go ahead and just start to bring some awareness back to your body. Maybe wiggling your fingers and toes, maybe rolling your wrists and ankles, maybe touching each one of your fingertips to your thumb. Go ahead and extend the arms out overhead, legs out long, stretching out everything at once. Pulling both knees into your chest one more time, maybe rocking side to side or forward and backward. Maybe coming into happy baby if that feels better. Just rolling over onto one side or the other. Whenever you're ready, keeping your eyes closed, pressing yourself up into a seated position on your mat. Inhaling both arms overhead. Exhaling hands to heart center. Thank you all for letting me guide you through your practice today.